I would not continue to survive at Nearpod if I did not look at our content that we were already creating and create a strategic plan to repurpose that across all of our other channels. It saves my sanity, it gives me a North Star, and it helps me plan and create content faster. And all of this content is going to funnel up to our business goal. Hey everyone, it's Amber Calderon. Welcome back to my channel. This is a place for teacher content creators and business owners to grow and, most importantly, scale their business. I am so excited for today's video, Repurposing Content with a Purpose. Repurposing content is a way to use your previous content and revitalize it so it's working harder for your SEO. Additionally, it's going to strengthen your brand voice and your niche because you're spreading the same topics across other channels that your audience follows you on. I would not continue to survive at Nearpod if I did not look at our content that we were already creating and create a strategic plan to repurpose that across all of our other channels. It saves my sanity, it gives me a North Star, and it helps me plan and create content faster. And all of this content is going to funnel up to our business goals. You ready to do that for yours? If you're new here, I would love for you to peek around the Teacher Marketing YouTube playlist. And if you want more free content like this, please be sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel so you never miss a teacher marketing tip with me. Okay, let's get into the video. What is repurposing content and why should you care about it? Repurposing content involves adding to or heavily altering your existing forms of content. And this sounds a little vague, but that's because there are so many forms of media that you can repurpose your content into. As I'm talking about this, I want you to get a sheet of paper out and I want you to write down all of the channels that are important to your business. Remember, your channels are going to look different than mine. There are so many ways to cross-pollinate the work that you're already doing, and I'm gonna get your gears turning in this video. Repurposing content is going to allow you to reach people that you missed the first time, because here's a secret, not everybody is looking at your content the second you post it. I know, I'm not trying to be a buzzkill on this channel, but it is what it is, so let's figure out how to reach them together. For example, if your channel is Twitter and you sent out one tweet promoting your blog post, the lifespan of a tweet is about 2 minutes. So you're not gonna hit your audience, you're not gonna reach a new audience if you only promote that one time. So how can you get creative thinking about ways to stretch that blog content or that YouTube content on Twitter so that it's gonna reach everyone? So that's just one way to do it. How can I stretch the content on one particular channel? The second is, how can I take this existing content and spread it across the other channels that are important to my business so I can fuel my content strategy and streamline my content creation process into content topics? So then not only am I able to plan and create faster, but it's all with a purpose and everything's funneling up again to your business goals. The best part about repurposing content is that it's going to help you create content so much faster because you're not having to create content from scratch. And I know you're gonna hear me say two things over and over again because I'm trying to get it in your head. It's gotta funnel up to your business goals and it's gonna make everything faster. Okay, now that you're getting your feelers out for what repurposing content is and why it's important for your business, now let's talk about how you even decide what content to recycle. Here I go again. Don't get mad at me. Always have clear goals in mind. You may not like that I keep saying that, but if you are just putting something out there and just spraying and praying and there's no intentionality behind it, what business goal is that meeting for you? Not saying that we don't all do that from time to time, but if you're trying to actually create a strong content strategy and plan your content for at least over a month, if not 60 days in advance, you can't just play like bingo dabbing wherever you wanna go. It's all gotta connect the dot. It also shouldn't just be because I'm telling you to. Now, repurposing content is also great if you have new goals in mind. For example, let's say you're trying to now get into email marketing, which I really love email marketing. I love mapping all of that, the onboarding experience, the trigger emails. We're just not there yet, but if that's something you're interested in, make sure you like this video and kind of let me know. So If you have new goals in mind, such as let's say you have an email list and you're really trying to grow it because you want to start converting those people and nurturing them through email flows. With these new goals in mind, now think of the content that you're creating across other channels. How can that provide value to your email list? How can those things that you're creating for your TPT products, a piece of it can be a gated piece of content that unlocks if somebody subscribes to your email list? Again, thinking about what your particular business goals are. Now, repurposing can involve changing the entire piece of content or creating an entirely new piece of content for in a different form of media. For example, let's say I have a YouTube video and I want to change the intent of that YouTube video. I may then tweak the YouTube video, maybe pull apart a specific piece of the YouTube video to go in depth on. And it's gonna have the same goal, which is whatever that conversion is that I've set for the first one. The second is, let's say I wanna take that YouTube video and then come up with a templated way to create short form media for my Instagram. And I'm going to make it into a series, and then I know every Wednesday I'm gonna post X. So that's another way to take your existing content and transform. Right now, we're talking about how to decide what content to recycle. So the first is start with your goals in mind. What are those goals that you're trying to achieve? And with those goals, are you looking to reach a particular audience or sell a specific product? The best repurposed content is going to funnel up to those goals. Let me give you an example. I want to drive buzz for Teacher Marketing Academy. So this video is just a tiny, minuscule piece of the entire content strategy vault. This is one piece in the repurposing with purpose of the content strategy vault. So this video is only touching a piece of it. But if you like this content and you're like, wait, I really need her to go more in depth about this, then make sure you subscribe to my Teacher Marketing Academy waitlist down below, because I will send you an email when it officially unlocks. See what I did there? See how I'm using this video to drive buzz? Think about that with your products as well. Deciding what to recycle your content. You now have your goals, you know what your particular business goals are, and now let's pick your pieces of content. My first suggestion is to pick evergreen pieces of content, content that's applicable for any time of year. There is nothing worse than decide you're gonna make a test prep repurposed content strategy plan in the middle of test prep season, and then you haven't yet built that muscle memory and created those routines for you to repurpose that content. You might fall off the wagon. Think about like working out, right? We want to start small, then gradually get bigger, and then you're out of testing season and you're not done with the content, and now you can't even deploy it. So something to keep in mind is if you can work towards the evergreen pieces of content, it's going to help make sure it's applicable for any time of the year and you can recycle it 12 months out of the year. One of my second tips to determine which content you recycle is to look at your high performing content. Check your Google Analytics or your website, YouTube, Instagram analytics, any channel that is your area of focus. What content drove the most views, impressions, engagement? That's content your audience is interested in your particular niche. So how can you repurpose that into other channels that you have, or stretch on that content just a little bit more to continuously engage your audience? Remember that paper that I told you to pull out? Now I want you to start writing these down. What content is performing well? And then start thinking and jotting down ideas. Just get a huge brain dump going. So you have your goals, you know how, which channels at least you're going to repurpose your content on. Now it's time to actually develop your content. And there's a lot of different types of media out there, so let's please narrow it down to just a few. It's great to have all of these grand ideas, but if you are not executing on these ideas, you are wasting your time planning to get zero results. After you decide on the specific forms of content that you want to do, choose a couple of tactics that's going to drive your personal goals. After you decide on which content pieces you want to repurpose, pick just a couple of tactics that you want to do with that content in order to repurpose it into other forms of media. Remember, these should drive your personal goals. Are you still a little bit confused? I'm going to share with you my business goals and how I create a content strategy for those business goals in order to help you think intentionally about your repurpose plan. Now, keep in mind, I'm only giving you just a short, quick snippet of my goals. I definitely have an entire Airtable base to help me organize, and those that are a part of my Teacher Marketing Academy will actually see that more in depth. So one of my main business goals is that I want to get monetized on YouTube in the next 5 months. That is my goal, and so that is why I am trying to create consistent content for the YouTube algorithm so that it knows that I want to be a key player in the YouTube game. So not only am I creating this existing content, but I am now repurposing my YouTube content into blog form content, because my blog has been around for years and my YouTube is very new. So my blog has the SEO weight that it can carry my YouTube channel and drive more traffic. Additionally, putting this content on my blog is also going to help me fuel my Pinterest, which is going to drive more traffic to my blog, and that's going to increase my AdSense revenue because I diversify my income. I embed my YouTube video into my blog post, so then those that may not want to exactly read the blog can go to my YouTube and continue watching, and it's going to drive up my watch hours so then I can get monetized quickly. The second way that I'm trying to reach my business goals with YouTube is that in addition to repurposing my content on my blog, I have now started to repurpose my YouTube content into short forms of media for Instagram. So from now on, every Monday, I am going to post a video promoting my YouTube video. And then on Thursday, I am going to create a reel that gives a tip about a previous YouTube video that I've created in order to stretch the content that I've already created and drive awareness of my YouTube channel. Now, to think even bigger, all of these topics are about teacher marketing, and my goal for the entire month of March is to drive awareness and buzz of Teacher Marketing Academy and my coaching calls. So you'll notice that everything that I am doing is plugging Teacher Marketing Academy. I'm trying to come up with repurposing content tactics that are gonna drive to that goal. So when the vault officially opens, there is now interest and they've considered my products and are more likely to make that decision and convert. Notice how each of these business goals serves a purpose, which is going to lead to a greater purpose. I hope sharing these business tactics will help you think more strategically, not that you're not already, but just from a different lens, giving you my personal experience, so then you can create the content strategy that best fits for you. And if you would like to create a content strategy in my Teacher Marketing Academy, then please make sure you sign up for the waitlist down below so you can get first access when the vaults open. You're ready to develop your content, but what exactly are the forms of media that you could possibly repurpose your content to? I'm going to share 4 ways that you can fuel your content with tactics about each one. The first one is you can republish and redirect your content. You can record your content. You can visualize your content, and you can group your content. Republishing content is exactly what I just said I was doing with my YouTube video and my blog. I'm taking my YouTube content and I'm republishing it on my blog post. I'm not having to create any new thoughts or ideas from scratch. It's the same form of content. The second way that you can do this is having guest posts or guest bloggers. You could be a guest writer for someone else's blog. How can you take one piece of a bigger piece of content that you've created and just talk about that one piece, but then it drives awareness back to your channel? So these are just 2 ways that you can republish your existing content. The second way that you can fuel your content is recording your existing content. This can happen in the form of webinars, podcasts, YouTube videos, and online courses. For example, if you have a YouTube channel, how can you also have a separate microphone or something in place where you are also recording that crisp audio quality for a podcast? If one of your goals is to grow your email list, how can you take your other forms of content and then create a webinar to share more in depth? Or to honestly, sometimes you can just share the same stuff and slightly tweak it and your people will not notice. It's like kind of mind blowing. It really is, but just like, it is what it is. But so you can have them sign up for your email list in order to get the link to attend your webinar. And now you're providing value, you're making yourself an expert in that particular niche that you're talking about, and you're growing your subscriber list. The next way that you can fuel your content is to help your audience visualize your existing content. Infographics, quote images, media snippets. How can you take a powerful statement that you said in a podcast or a YouTube video or grab it from your blog post and create a quote image of that quote that you said and drive back to that form of content? You can also create carousel images for different forms of media. For example, if I wanted to, these are four ways to fuel your content ideas. That's a carousel image that I could then use on Instagram and then have the last slide say, want to hear me talk about this more in depth? And then post my, and then show my YouTube channel. The fourth way that you can fuel your content is to group. It's my favorite, as you can tell as I'm smiling. Grouping your existing content. This is the form of thematic campaigns, an email series, or an ebook. I love thematic campaigns. We will talk more in detail in Teach a Marketing Academy, but whoa, 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 that is where I am today because of thematic campaigns. If you have a bunch of forms of content about back to school, and classroom management or anything of the sort, how can you string them into a cohesive package and then deploy them across parts of your other channels in a thematic way? Another example is your email list. How can you provide value to your email subscribers so then they are more likely to open, increase your open rate, your click-through rate, ultimately the conversion, because they now again see you as an expert and they're like, oh, they're recommending this product, click purchase. Taking that content and creating an email series is going to help you with the email marketing haul because it can be a lot of work if you don't have a plan in place. And the second is batching these all into an ebook, free or paid, in order to repurpose that content into a way other people might consume that form of media. Okay, y'all, that's it for this video. Comment below and let me know, which piece of content are you going to repurpose and how are you going to repurpose it? Also, drop your social media links below because I would love to see that come to life and be your biggest cheerleader. I really and truly mean it. This whole community has inspired me more than you know, and I'm just so thankful for each and every one of y'all. I know I say that, but like, I really do mean it. If you like this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel because this lets me know that you want to see more free teacher marketing tips like this. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next Sunday in my next video. Bye, y'all.